their body. The family's attitude digs their kitchen in their hut for burying that dead body. Is it your Kerala model development? Is it your independence? Is it your independence? Is it your democracy and socialism?
We are conducting Onam here, you know. But this time we are not conducting Onam, but we are conducting Kerala cultural festival with some revolutionary changes. You know, we are offering non-vegetarian food here. Maveli, you should come for the event and we can make it as a grand success.
Forms the cultural program that you are speaking about. Is it the cultural program of entire Kerala? Or is it the culture of a dominant upper caste elite culture? In the history of your cultural festival, have you ever introduced any Dalit and Adivasi cultural art forms in this campus? Program. You are celebrating Onam and promoting Kerala upper caste culture as the real culture representation of Kerala. Their way of dressing, their habit of food, they are cultural programs you are celebrating here for many years. In this context, some of my children argued for their proportional cultural representation in your cultural program. And also they wanted to eat their delicious food, beef. But you could not tolerate it. You try to make use of my children's secular value and try to make them to eat pork. Is it not because of your hatredness towards a particular community? Now is your innovative chicken politics. You are acting as you are the progressive and trying to submerge my children's argumentation of deconstruction. Is it a justice act? That is why some of my children walk away from your group. They are children. If you are conducting your cultural program, you should learn some lessons from our Northeast friends. Because when they conduct their cultural program, they have given equal space to their different tribal groups. In Kerala, can I ask one thing? In your Kerala, in your school festival, in your college festival, in your university festival, or in the public space, have you ever given any space to Dalit and tribal culture? Have you ever given? Don't try to bring that dirty culture into a proactive space like Hyderabad University.
Now we believe that one thing a year visiting us, but we could understand that this is the first year you are coming to see us. Then why are you coming to see us?
As you said, this is the first time I am coming to see you all after my assassination. This is the first time because this is the 21st century, Ambedkar era, in which the dark golden people are going to be enslaved from the yoke and suffering for slavery. I know Hyderabad University is the hotbed of subaltern politics. I came to know that Ambedkar Student Association succeeded to make one of Dalit students as the president of this university. my children. When I go to Kerala, I could see still my people are in the land struggle because they do not have land. They do not have any basic things for their livelihood. When I go to Tamil Nadu, the people are telling of the massacre I against Dalits in Tamil Nadu. In the part of Karnataka, still casteism is practicing and visible atrocities are taking place in Karnataka. When I come here in Andhra Pradesh, I could see still in some of the places the adivasis system is practicing. Chandur and Karantur, the Dalit massacre is given again and again repeating. And the statues of Baba Sahib are Ambedkar is demolishing. And genius practices like manual scavenging is still practicing in India. Even after 6.5 decades of our independent life, this is the situation of our country. My dear children, you are the young children from various parts of India are not taking responsibility of our society, are not taking the responsibility of the future of our people, then who will take the responsibility? Then what will be the future of our people? Beyond our caste and gender identity and regional identity, all of us should join our hands together for a better future. That is why I came here. Even though if you do not want to listen to me and take my words into consideration, I will go and I never come back again.
Bali Raja, we won't allow you to go back until we are here.
We, the Ambedkar Students Association, have been fighting for the rights of depressed classes, founded on the ideals of educate, agitate and organize. Bali Raja, we have been organized since from 1993 to fight against the inhuman and atrocious incidents of caste practices, where before 1993 we didn't have the right to walk in a group, we didn't have the right to talk in a group, we didn't have the right to organize as a group. Then under the leadership of the research scholars of NRS, Ambedkar Students Association has been founded, and from then it has launched relentless struggles. Like it has fought against the indolent administration for implementation of reservation, and also it has fought for the self-respect of all Dalit Bahujan communities. Not only struggles, it has also made many sacrifices, where in 2002 10 Dalit students were rusticated by the administration for protesting against the practice of caste system here. And where High Court also has delivered a judgment in favor of the 10 students. And we didn't stop at there. We have taken the slogan of Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, where he said, "Let us prove by our conduct that we are going to unite with all communities of this country to take them to march, to take them on the march, which on a road which leads to unity. And not only the wisdom, not only the power you have to carry them with the wisdom." And we are moving forward on that, and we are uniting SC, ST, OBC and minority students on this unified platform and fighting against the caste oppression in our campus. Mahabali, we wanted to know how we have to deconstruct this, our existing past, and how we have to construct the future on the basis of marginalized politics and also on the basis of subaltern ideology.
It is amazing, my children, you could achieve a lot. All of my children, all of us are human beings. Our life is the gift of Mother Earth. Let justice flourish. Let there be peace. If you wanted to see things change, there should not be any caste and caste discrimination. You should demolish barbaric Brahmanism and the sacred text. All of you should inculcate brotherhood and sisterhood in your heart. Our women should get equality in the society, and they should be in the prime place of government. They will look after our society like a mother. They should be look after our mother and the society like a mother. My dear children, if you realize these all things, these are the inspiration I would like to give before you from the unbroken past which I have had in my history. My dear children, if you have taken these things into consideration, this is the beginning of new life. And this is the beginning of new celebration. It is nothing but is the Resurgent birthday. It is the Resurgent birthday. The celebration of Dalit Carnival. This is the celebration of our life. This is the celebration of our culture. This is the celebration of our heart and faith. And this is the celebration for making an unbroken society. Dear children, if you have these intentions in your mindset, you are not alone in this battlefield. You are not alone in this battlefield. Billions of our people are there in the battlefield. They are fighting for enslaving our people from the yoke and the shackles of slavery. If all of us go join our hands together, we can bring an unbroken society as possible as early. Dear children, in order to make a solidarity with the children, one of our well-known personalities has come here. Who is that?
Good.
Yeah, he has come. Yep. Who has